Alright, and I'm not gonna be the only one singing. This guy right here, he's trying to hide. He's gonna be singing with me. This song is called Uptown Funk, and whoever is standing or even sitting, come and get your asses off your seats and join us as we dance. Let's go!
Thank you. Thank you, Savio.
It's a very good thought, a very good platform, and I think music kisi ke jadad, kisi ka haq nahi hai. Everybody who loves music has a chance to sing, to enjoy himself. You may be a bathroom singer, you may be a karaoke singer, you may enjoy yourself in any which way. Professional singing is a totally a different ball game altogether. But even amateurs have the right to sing, enjoy themselves, and I know thousands of people, hundreds of people who actually enjoy themselves singing karaoke songs. So with the karaoke, I mean, singing songs with the karaoke. And I think it's a very nice hobby, a good pastime, and you never know, it may become a big profession at one time.
No, I think that even though they might not have the professional training, we've seen that they're very passionate about music. So that really comes across, and they're doing a great job, and I wish them all the best. Even though they don't have the professional training, I think it's wonderful because they have the passion, and they're doing a wonderful job, and I wish them all the best.
Have you ever participated in karaoke yourself?
Of course, I've participated, and all my friends, all of us have a great time. I think karaoke nights are the most popular nowadays. I think almost every weekend we're having a karaoke night, so yeah, it's definitely fun. Whether you sing or no, whether you're trained or no, it's definitely fun to sing on a karaoke night, yeah.
नहाना चाहिए कि गाना आए या ना आए गाना चाहिए अरे गाना आए या ना आए गाना चाहिए ओ बच्चा ठंडे ठंडे पानी से नहाना चाहिए ओए ठंडे ठंडे पानी से नहाना चाहिए गाना आए या ना आए गाना चाहिए अरे गाना आए या ना आए गाना चाहिए I just want to say that Ghana, I'm not trying to tell about anyone, but just that it's not professionally singing, it's that you should enjoy yourself singing and keep singing, whether it's karaoke or whichever way you want.
No, I think it's wonderful. And
Karaoke World Championship,
because I think karaoke is one of the best forms of your performability to come out, because you're really actually you're just concentrating only on your lyrics, your vocals and your performance, because the music is coming in from elsewhere, which is the karaoke, which is called the minus one. So your vocals, the way you look, the way you present yourself, it's the best way to actually check out and test your performability and also test the pulse of the crowd, the audience. What are they wanting? What are they grooving to? And of course, lyrically, it makes you very strong, because a lot of singers, while singing, forget lyrics. But in KWC, in karaoke, you cannot afford to, you know, lose the lyrics, right? So that's one very big up there. And yeah, so I've been a part of it because honestly, whenever I need to unwind, I've always just been unwinding to karaoke. It's such a de-stress. It's such an amazing... A lot of people are not even singers. The singer just comes out of them. It makes a singer out of you. So you never know. Karaoke can actually lead you to become a very professional, big hit singer. You never know.
So you always associated with different like just now, with the amazing fashion show and the performances.
Yeah, because I feel like, you know, everything becomes very stereotypical in reality shows. So these kind of platforms, like KWC is a platform at the end of the day. These platforms provide something very, very alternative to people who actually have another kind of talent. So why should people who have a talent not they should also be shining in the spotlight. They should also be allowed an opportunity to express themselves. So really, here's to KWC forever and ever and ever. And Savio Dcouza for actually making this so passionately bigger and bigger each time, and international and global now, of course.
Have you done karaoke singing yourself?
Always. I love karaoke singing because it's just... I remember in pubs and clubs, when there are karaoke nights, people cheer you on. The energy is so amazing. Karaoke gives you amazing energy to sing, actually.
And you'd like to sing something for us?
Okay, I'm not going to sing my own song because we're talking about karaoke, right? So I'm going to sing a song which I normally sing in karaoke, and people think that, wow, I mean, she's 10 on 10 here. So I'll sing, you can dance, you can jive, having the time of your life. Ooh, see that girl, watch that scene, digging the dancing queen.
I'd never dared doing it because I know I don't sing really well, but these singers over here.
Have you ever done karaoke yourself?
No, actually not. I've always been fond of it, but I never dared doing it because I know I sing like a dying walrus.
And so how does it be part of an initiative like this?
Untrained, like they sang so well, and also it's on the international level where they all get to meet to represent India at a very international level. So actually I feel really very nice being a part of it.
And you've been part of the film.
Yeah.
So what else can we expect from
Splitsvilla? Was my first reality show. Before that, I have never experienced a reality, being a part of a reality show ever. I've done movies before this, so that was really a very different experience for me. I'm looking forward for upcoming reality shows, and also talks are going on for movies and ad films, but I can't disclose anything about it now.
Thank you.
It's a very good initiative because you know, a lot of people don't get a chance, and we in the industry are always looking at people who are very talented, or people who
you know, come from very trained backgrounds. But this KWC, the initiative is giving an opportunity to people who are not trained but might have a lot of talent. So this could be something very fresh, something very new, and something which helps a lot of these singers out here to probably get them a chance to do a playback or cut an album or something. So you never know. Well, I just finished a short film with Luke Kenny called Stephen King, I'm Your Number One Fan, which is going to release soon on YouTube and all the digital media. And yet, I'm doing another couple of more feature films, one called Port Louis, which starts in Mauritius, end of the year. So I'm looking forward to that, and another one in Delhi. So that's a comedy. And a couple of few more things coming in, so I'm still a little tight-lipped about them, and I hope they work out.
Thanks so much.
Bye.
So we see a lot of energy here today.
Yeah, yeah.
We have a lot of fun.
No, it's lovely. I mean, I think this is my second year with Savio's KWC, and it's such an amazing, happy vibe. Because, I mean, you know, first of all, it's something to do with music. And being a singer, having sung 7,000 jingles, having sung on so many Bollywood films, it's...
Bolna. 2 minutes bolna. Just ask them to hold for 2 minutes.
Lots of energy, and it's so, so amazing because Savio comes with that energy. He's so, how would you say, he's so charismatic as a person. So, I mean, he loves to do things in a big way. And KWC every year just seems to get bigger and better. So it's a fabulous atmosphere here. Sure. I mean, this is the latest song that I've sung, Nashe Se Chadi Gayi, so I'll sing a couple of lines from it. It's also the French part, which Vishal Dadlani wanted me to sing and write. So I wrote the French lyrics as well. So I'll sing the little part for you. Ton sourire, mon sincère, je suis fou de toi. Le désir dans mes veines, guéri par ta voix. Ton sourire, mon sourcil, je suis fou de toi. Thank you.
Thank you.
Merci.
How's it going, everybody, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you so much for joining us. First off, I want to request all of you to please give a big round of applause to the TAP team that's actually put a lot of effort. And to Mario and Rado, who's been a very vital part of this evening. Thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen.